that's ballin', ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing. Yeah, you know I done it. Now there's no discussion, bitch. I'm ballin', ballin'. I made a promise to my mama. I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas. What's up, everybody? It's your boy Fat Dollars, aka Lockdown, aka Clamp Guy, bringing you some more Madden 17 Ultimate Team gameplay. Roll to the ultimate ticket burns. This is a quick look at my updated roster. Somebody in the comment section wanted to see the squad. So this is the squad. This is my offense. We're gonna get to my defense right now. Everything is still the same. Only thing we got is a couple people in different positions. As far as who was number one and who was number two, we got Lattimore, Brown, Humphrey, and y'all know that I like to switch in a lot of people on different sets. I don't keep my team exactly how it is. This is just for chemistry wise, just to make sure that everybody get the block shares they supposed to have the zones they supposed to have the man they supposed to have. This is the wild card game. We are two games away from 98 ultimate ticket, Artie Burns. You can see it's 7-7 right now, and I'm gonna tell you right now, Leonard Fournette went off this game. This guy was a D-line user, and you know if I'm playing against a D-line user, I'm gonna try to pound the rock to the opposite side. As we come out right here, getting all our blocks, and we break open, man, and we get all the way down to the 41-yard line. So we end up taking the field goal right there. I got the green circle of death. I tried to do a verticals play, and Randy Moss just didn't get the animation. Right here, my opponent is trying to go deep, and Lattimore is not having it. He is swatting it down. Every time somebody go deep, I automatically click onto the person. Once again, Lattimore is not having it. He is locked down. If you don't got that Lattimore, go pick him up, man. He could be your number one or number two. But I suggest that you don't press. It don't matter what they press rating is, as Dunlap gets in with a block share. That's his second sack. We had 7 sacks. Yes, I said it. 7 sacks in this gameplay. And my opponent was setting up the run to go deep. That was his whole game plan, which is about 70-80% of people game plan. Some of them just like to chuck it right away. He actually had a type of scheme that he was trying to stick to, as we come down with the pick right there. And that boy Hooker with about 95-96 zone, man, he plays exactly like his stats say. He can lay the boom, not too many fumbles, but he can get big hit animations, and he can play good zone. As he tries to go deep right there with 95 speed Humphreys, and we just knock it down, man. As we get further in the gameplay, you're gonna see me get out of the cover three. I stayed in the cover three a lot because he played a lot of small packages, and he was running with Ezekiel Elliott. Sooner or later, I'm gonna switch into my dime 236 that I showed y'all a few videos back. So make sure you hit that thumbs up button. If you didn't check that out, go check it out. As you can see, we set it up right now, and you can get the screamers up in there, or you can get the block sheds, man. These big fat linemen cannot keep up with all these screamers and these block sheds. As once again on 4th and 7, Willie Brown, not the fastest speed, but he got pretty good hit power and block shed, man. So if he's coming in, he's coming in. Just like Night Train Lane, I usually put Deion Sanders as my blocker, as we hand it off to Fournette again, and he's making everybody miss. He's off to the races, to the 10, to the 5, and he goes in for a touchdown. He had 4 touchdowns in this contest, man. We had 7 sacks, not including the halves, man. So we had about 9 sacks total. 4 interceptions in this gameplay. Only 2 games away from a free ultimate ticket, as Prescott is rolling out. You can see Dunlap, 2.5 sacks, man. I don't know how they compute the halves, but he got 2.5 sacks right now. My defense is doing a thing, man. Like I always tell y'all, mix the nickel blitz in, because that would just throw your opponent off. After you run 2 or 3 blitzes the same time, they usually find the opening. As you can see, he tries to go underneath, and Hooker comes and lays the boom, just like I told y'all, man. So we right back on offense, 24-10 at the end of the third quarter, and we just gonna dump it off to the speed DeSean Jackson, and he's tiptoeing on the sidelines, gets us all the way down to the 12-yard line, man. If y'all enjoy these gameplays, let me know. We got all types of beef to the left, so I'm gonna run it. Wait for the hole to open up, and Fournette is in the end zone once again, man. 99 overall for Fournette, man. He's way better than 99 overall. Marshawn Lynch, this game is all about the power backs, as my opponent comes right back out in the fourth quarter, and he's trying to run the ball again, and I don't mind that. I will stay in the cover three all game. The game is broken.
Madden 18. I hope they fix everything, man. If you play flex, they can hit you deep with Julio Jones over the top of your cloud flex and all that type of stuff as my opponent comes right out again in another run. And eventually, we're going to hit him with a hit stick, and that's going to slow my opponent down because he don't want to fumble. And I think it's on this play right here. He comes out in the run again. We knock him backwards, and boom! Lay the hit stick on him, and that's going to be the last time that he run the ball on that play right there. So he comes out in the play action. We sending that fire to him. I'm sending everybody in. I'm lurking underneath, and we get another sack. And that's Reddick, man. That boy is a beast himself. I said that boy is a beast himself, man. Second and 14, 31-10. I know my opponent has to put the ball in the air. I am lurking underneath, and look at that. Dual edge. His third sack of the game, man. His third sack, Reddick got a sack, and we gonna get a couple more sacks too, man. Willie Brown, he got a couple sacks, man. We went crazy on defense. And if he don't get a sack, he gotta chuck it deep. And if he throws it short, which my user is right there, I'm gonna pick you off. You know how the clamp guy do it, man. We come right back. He's using the D-line again. We are following our blocks. And there's Fournette once again going into the end zone, man. I love this car. Like I said, if you got an offensive scheme, you don't have to come out and chuck the ball. The game is a little more boring when you're putting the ball on the ground. Everybody like the pass, use the run, use the Rams offense and stuff. As we come down with a user pick with Paul Cross right there, man. I'm all about locking my opponents down, man. This year, defense is way more fun than offense. My opponent is using his D-line again, and we chuck it to Randy Moss, and the equalizer comes into full effect. Look at the top of the screen. I even got that as my name, man. Equalizer, because I know if I lose the game 98% of the time, it's out of my hands. Only 50% of Madden 17 is skill. So you can never say that you're the best opponent. You can be happy about certain things that happen, but this game is not skill. Maybe Madden 18 will be skill-based, but 50% of this game is skill. The other 50% is flukes, equalizer, and animations, man. As we send that heat again, and Willie Brown comes up with his third sack. It's 3.5, man. And when he throws it short, the clip guide is right there, man. If y'all enjoyed it, make sure y'all hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Madden 18 is going to be, this is going to be the channel where you're going to want to get the best Madden 18 news, the best Madden 18 tips. It's all love. Let's go.